Hi Scorpio, welcome to Omkara Tarot and let's do a mid-month love check-in. Scorpio, these are general collective readings, okay? Will not resonate with each and every one of you. So take what works for you, leave the rest. And also, these cards are flying today. What's wrong with you? Stay. Okay, now let's go. So Scorpio, big thank you to all my subscribers, believe it or not. Channel is barely 3 months old and we've crossed over 1,000 subscribers. Thank you so much for all your love. And I have a Three of Pentacles which came face up, so I kept it. Let's see what's happening, what it needs to say to us. And if you're new here, Scorpio, newcomers, we are a small Omkara family. We meet here weekly for love readings, monthly readings, money, work readings. So do join us, subscribe to the channel, and we welcome you here. And let me also tell you, I'm putting down two sets of cards. One is for you, one is for your person. Center, have your mutual energy. Feel free to flip the sides if you feel you resonate more on the other side. Bottom of the deck, I have the Six of Cups. So let's see, Scorpio, your first card here is the Devil. Fine way to start a reading. And the Two of Cups. Okay, that's not so bad. Madly in love. Nine of Cups. Page of Cups. Five of Swords. And the Two of Wands. Okay, let's see for person two. The Sun, Chariot, Emperor, Hanged Man, Ten of Cups, and the Five of Wands. Wow. So good cards, and then suddenly, boom, there's a Devil or there's a Five of Wands. What's going on? So let's start with person A. Scorpio, Spirit, why is the Devil here for person A? Somebody is obsessively thinking about somebody who walked away from their life. Okay, this person is obsessive. This person is obsessive about this person, the person B. And maybe they had a lot of love for this person, or this was a marriage maybe, or a long-term connection, because I did see the six of Cups here, which means, you know, you've known each other for a long time, maybe a decade or more, and maybe this has sweet memories from the past. So this was, maybe you had happy times in the past, and person A, all they do is obsessively think about this person who has maybe now walked away from their life. But they are in this mode, person A is in this mode, just all the time by themselves, obsessing over this Two of Cups, which kind of didn't work out for them. This person was their love, right? And made them very, very happy with the Nine of Cups here. Made them very happy. So let's take a card. They're trying to manifest this love back into their life. They're wondering how, what can they do to get this person who walked away from their life come back into a union of a Two of Cups with them again, because they now are realizing that this is the person that made them the happiest. Maybe they've tried other people here and there and it hasn't worked, and all they can do is think about the person, the one that got away. Yeah, this person walked away and then refused, I think, to come back. But person A wants them to come back now, and they are in this mode where they can't sleep at night, they're stressed all the time, they keep plotting and planning and worrying as to how I can manifest, this person to come back into my life with the Chariot in reverse. They're even thinking now, we can come back together, work together. Come back into like a family dynamic with the Three of Pentacles here, and they may be even thinking of somehow taking an apology to person B. But they're very stressed out, very, very, very stressed out. They don't know how. Maybe a lot of things went wrong And yes, there is a, I forgot, there is a Five of Swords here, which means that one person was very mean and manipulative in the past, and person A knows that. They know what they've done in the past and why this person walked away. And even though now they want to take this offer or apology or whatever, they are wondering how to do it because they know the stress and tension is eating them up because they are remembering of the way they maybe they behaved with person B. They were always, you know, cutting them short, but making them feel small, hurting them, just mind manipulation, publicly humiliating them maybe. They did a lot of sneaky stuff, right, to make person B feel bad. And now they themselves are in the stage where they realize that, oh my God, this person has walked away because of maybe my own faults. And now what do I do? Now I realize that this is the only person who I could have, you know, lived my happily ever after with. And how can I manifest this person back? So they are right now in this plotting and planning stage, right? They're thinking. They are thinking, not just thinking, they are obsessively thinking. So Scorpio, if you are here, I don't know, but if you are here, please know, be a little aware, this person is still very obsessed about you. So let's see, what is this apology that they want to bring to you? Person A's apology, yeah, they are going to say, okay, I'm no longer now going to be in my pride and ego, and I surrender to you, I will never behave this way again. Maybe earlier they were very prideful, or they were always, you know, trying to be one up on person B. So this is their way of saying, I'm sorry that, you know, I'm not strong without you, and I promise I will never ever, you know, try and do these things ever again, and I won't be in that egocentric space that I may have been in the past. So let's check out this Two of Wands. What are they planning? The Spirit, what are they planning here? Person A, what are they planning? They are planning how to go to this queen and not get her wrath. They know she's going to be very angry. They know she's very upset with them. They know that she is not willing to even think of a fresh beginning with them. And here they are standing in their balcony, just thinking of what can I say or what can I do to flip these energies, straight, so that she won't like really bite my head off and tell me to get out the minute I go to her. Let's see person B. Person B is in the sunshine energy, with the sun shining and the chariot already moving forward, totally in control of one's life, feeling victorious. This person has found self-worth, Scorpio. After this divide in these two people happened, person B started totally focusing on themselves, right? They went within. They were stuck for some time, maybe. They went within. They got enlightened. They picked themselves up. And I think they made a huge success of themselves. Now people are cheering for them. They are applauding them. They are maybe a huge success. Probably a star, okay? With the sun energy and the Six of Wands, this is like a superstar. Okay, superstar. And this chariot, look at the way this person is progressing in their life. And they, I think, have managed to get back total control of their life now with the Emperor energy. And they don't seem to need anyone right now. They also have the Ten of Cups. They're emotionally also very satisfied. So let's start clarifying these cards. The Spirit, what is this chariot for person B? They've let go. They've dropped this burden altogether. And since they've dropped this burden, Scorpio, they are now feeling so light that they are charging ahead in their own life and doing a great job of it as well. They felt very restricted in the past, okay? They felt so restricted in the past. They felt chained to this previous, relationship or whatever, in a very toxic kind of way, where they went totally quiet. They lost their voice in this relationship altogether. It's almost like they lost themselves in this very controlling dynamic here. This was their first card, right? Person A's first card was the Devil. So person B has now kind of has released this with the Ten of Wands reverse. Person B has released this devil energy and they have this high priestess upright to say, I'm going to now listen to only my spirit guides and my own intuition and follow my own path. Right? And they are doing that. They have the chariot there as well. So what's this emperor for them, spirit? They've taken control of their life. Person B is totally in control. Yet, and they are getting offers, right? They are getting offers. Now, this could be person A coming to person B with an offer. Or this could be somebody else. Okay? Because I do see a lot of competition for them. They have the five of wands here. And they also have the ten of cups, wish fulfillment. So, maybe a lot of people are vying right now for their attention, including person A. So let's see, why are they in the hangman's place right now? I don't think they're accepting anything. Yeah, they're just watching and waiting. They are getting offers, but they are not accepting anything. Maybe after what happened with them, they are very wary of, starting anything new. So they've kept themselves a bit stuck and they're watching and waiting to see what kind of offers are coming towards them. Yes, they do want a fresh new beginning and they do want a rebirth of their life, but I don't think they are in a big rush to rush into anything new. They are very emotionally satisfied at the moment, even in their solitude, because they have, I think, found their calling in life and they're doing well and they're emotionally happy. They've let go, they've healed from that, whatever was happening here. And yes, they seem quite emotionally satisfied here. Let's take a card for the ten of things are slow. Things are slow. They are not accepting any love offers right now, and maybe that's what's keeping them happy, because they feel that I don't want any drama in my life. So what is this five of wands finally? Five of wands. They I think a lot of people are fighting for their attention. Scorpio, this is you. You are it now, right? And you have so many people fighting for your attention that it's actually, giving you a little kick. You seem very, very happy, emotionally satisfied here, just with the attention you're getting. I don't see any connection. Yeah. You've been hurt very badly. Person B has been so badly hurt in the past. Now, just sitting and watching people vie for their attention is good enough for them. I don't think they want anything beyond that at the moment. Yeah, see, they don't want to make any decision right now. No decisions to be made and no offers being accepted. Just feeling very happy that, yes, they are still, in demand. So right now I don't see any connection between these two. This person is obsessed because somebody has left, and yes, this person has left and happy with it. Let's see your mutual energy if there is any. Yes, this could have been a marriage. Yeah, it's a world come to a close, but there is a message coming here. Let's see, spirit, what's this high priest here, the Hierophant? Okay. One more, spirit. Yeah, world twice. One more card, please, for the Hierophant. Okay, so what happened was here, this was a very, very committed relationship maybe in the past. It could have been a long-term relationship. You people were happy together maybe at one point in the past. You have some sweet memories here, but this could have been a marriage as well. But I think something happened here where one person, this wasn't like a God-made tower where suddenly out of the blue something happened and something broke down. This tower came down because of somebody, okay? Somebody kind of dropped the ball here. So one of you kind of knows that he or she is responsible for this relationship breaking down. Somebody just kind of, one person was working for the relationship and the other person just dropped the ball, okay? Didn't fight for it. And that led to this chapter of this marriage or this commitment coming to a total halt. Okay, but I have the world here again, so let's see if this also signifies a completion. Sometimes it can mean a beginning as well, so let's see. King of Wands in reverse. Okay, one more spirit with a mutual energy. One person here is now going to create some drama here, I think. Okay, they want to re-begin this. They want to restart this whole chapter once again, and they're coming in with quick communication here. They want a reunion. They want a reunion with person B. Okay, they want them to make a choice to choose them back again into coming into a commitment again, right? But I don't think it's happening, because this is a lose-lose situation here with the King of Wands in reverse. This is more trouble than anything else. Hope you'll be a bit mindful. Let's see what this message is. Page of Wands, Spirit. Yes, there's no going back to this. I'm sorry, Scorpio. As much as one person is fighting, okay, and in a very, not a very good way, fighting for this relationship to be back, I don't think the other person is accepting it. And this message is not going to be really accepted. Why? Because one or both people now will not want to go back to the past, because they are realizing that the love is lost now. And once the love is lost, Scorpio, you really can't push anything, right? So I think both of you are going to drop fighting for this now. This relationship doesn't seem to be, Four of Wands in reverse. So not this month, at least, Scorpio, I think this one is out. This one is out, yeah. This has been coming up for a long time, in all the readings. And I mean, I wish for whoever seeing this that something new would show up now. Let's take an angel blessing card for you, Scorpio. Yes, there's a pause button here. There's a pause button here, Scorpio. So now it's time to, look forward to the future. Keep your vision on the future. You never look back with the vision card. You always look ahead. Look at how this woman is, her eyes are totally fixed on her goal. So keep your eyes on your target for the future. Right now, this relationship is at a complete pause, right? And Spirit says you don't have to worry at all. This was maybe just a karmic lesson. And you're a very, very sweet, beautiful human being, and we are with you, and don't worry about a thing, we have your back. And just chill out, okay? Take some time out for yourself, and play music, enjoy, chill, and don't obsess too much, okay? If this person is obsessed by you, forget about it. And if you're obsessing, not worth it. There are lots of new soulmates that you'll meet soon. So that's all I have for you, Scorpio. Take care, love and light, and namaste to all of you.